A fish is taking over Taiwan's lakes. The sailfin catfish is a freshwater species native to South America. It was introduced to Taiwan in the 1980s as a pet that eats algae and can keep aquariums clean. But these household pets become insidious problems when they're released into the wild. Today, Taiwan's in an uphill battle to control its catfish invasion. Here's our Sunday special report.
This is Bihu Park in Taipei's Neihu district. Surrounded by mountains, this is a popular spot to relax and fish, or just to sit back and escape the city's hustle and bustle. But here, at this corner of the park, it's a storm of activity, cutting a stark contrast to the lake Serenity. These conservationists work together to carry a boat to the water, and then they set up a gill net. But what exactly are they working on?
Today, we're attempting to clear the lake of a type of fish called the sailfin catfish. This is an invasive species that has taken over the lake.
Bihu Park is a great place for Neihu residents to relax and go on walks, but few residents are aware of what lurks beneath the surface of its lake. The calm surface hides an unwelcome guest, the sailfin catfish, also commonly known as an algae eater. After placing the gill net for 2 hours, the group is ready to pull it in. In just 2 short hours, they have captured 37 sailfin catfish. Looking closer, one is greeted with the fish's small round eyes and its labyrinth-like skin pattern. Its coarse skin is covered in hard scales that form a sort of armored plating.
The sailfin catfish is not indigenous to Taiwan. It's from South America. There's a suitable environment for it there, as well as natural predators. But they don't have natural predators in Taiwan.
Some 30 years ago, the sailfin catfish was considered a must-have for aquariums, and it was imported into Taiwan. It was known as a garbage collector or algae eater.
The main purpose of algae eaters is to eat the algae that thrive in aquariums due to the lighting. Aquarium owners don't need to worry about frequently cleaning the aquarium. The algae eater does a very good job of that, saving people lots of time.
Algae eaters were imported for use inside aquariums. How did they end up out in the wild? Less than 2 kilometers away at Neihu Park, the same problem exists, an invasion of algae eaters.
When these algae eaters grow up, many aquarium owners discard them due to their offensive appearance. Others get rid of them due to their aggression to other fish in the aquarium.
Out in the wild, the fast-producing sailfin catfish can quickly become a problem. During its breeding season from May to August, a multitude of eggs is laid, creating an ecological catastrophe.
There was a study done by a master's student at National Taiwan University. It found that sailfin catfish can lay up to 6,000 eggs at a time. In my own calculations, I found that they laid up to 2,500 eggs.
About an hour's drive from Taipei, Bada Pond Ecological Park in Taoyuan has also fallen victim to the sailfin catfish. Of Taoyuan's 2,000 or so ponds, about 800 are used for irrigation. Some of those ponds are also used for aquaculture. In recent years, the sailfin catfish has been a source of grief for the aquaculture industry.
Algae eaters use up oxygen and consume feed. They eat other fish's feed. This creates losses for those of us who cultivate fish, but we don't have a solution for it.
This 20,000 ping pond in Taoyuan Xinyu district is teeming with sailfin catfish. According to aquaculture farmer Chen Qinghan, his net once drew up 1,000 catties of the fish in a single go. On the day we were there, we didn't catch many, but we could see signs of them in the pond. Sailfin catfish are omnivores. If they eat food meant for other species, they invariably add to the operating costs of aquaculture farmers. But what's of even greater concern is the harm that sailfin catfish can do to farmed fish.
They have an impact on the fish we raise, like the tilapia and the Taiwan sea bream. These fish are beautiful starting out, but then they get caught up in the net together with the sailfin catfish. They rub against each other in the net, and that helps us scale the fish. But the problem is that there's no market for these fish after they're scaled. They just can't be sold.
The aquaculture farmers here put tremendous resources into raising quality fish. But when they pull up their net, nearly one-fifth of the fish they net is algae eaters. The bed of this 3.5-ton truck is packed to the brim with sailfin catfish, each one at least 30 centimeters long. It's hard to imagine just how many of these fish are swimming about in the lake. A key question is how this invasive species, which has no natural predators, is affecting the local ecology.
Out in the wild, sailfin catfish can grow to 30 centimeters or more. In one day, it can eat between 3,000 and 5,000 fish eggs. That's a threat to other fish in the same environment, which will greatly drop in numbers. As a sailfin catfish has no natural predators, it can turn a diverse aquatic ecosystem into a single species environment.
Aside from the threat it presents to native species, the sailfin catfish's large size also means it has a voracious diet and produces a large amount of bodily waste. This can be ruinous for water quality.
The waste from these fish causes algae to flourish. The growth of the algae in turn upsets the balance in the ecosystem. What's worse is that without other plant life in the water to block the sunlight, the water temperature rises greatly and kills the algae. As they die, they absorb oxygen, which greatly depletes the water's oxygen levels.
In the past, Taoyuan would clean out its ponds and lakes, removing sailfin catfish in the process. For a time, it seemed like this was the ultimate solution. But in more recent years, due to spells of drought, Taoyuan has had to give up on this approach.
Now the number of algae eaters increases annually. In the past, we could drain the pond and clean it, and keep the numbers down that way. But now with the water shortages, it's not possible to drain ponds and refill them. That means that algae eaters are better able to reproduce.
Unable to drain ponds and lakes, the city has to rely on traditional methods to get rid of algae eaters. Using gill nets, workers catch large numbers of the invasive fish by hand. During breeding season, they are able to remove the fish's eggs, thereby reducing the number of new fish that are hatched.
In the early days, there were lots of indigenous fish here, and we would come here to fish. In early 2020, lots of newspaper and magazine reports were saying that the water here was infested with algae eaters, and even the experts gave up on dealing with the issue. I felt like the environment here was in a sad state of affairs, so I came here during the breeding season to see if I could remove some of the fish's eggs from the water.
But whether it's removing eggs during breeding season or removing the fish, neither solution is a quick fix.
If you catch these fish, there is still the difficult situation of what to do with them. The problem is that we don't know how many we will catch. Sometimes it's quite a lot, and then we need to have the park's custodial workers come take them away at the last minute. But the workers may not be free at that time. However, if you arrange in advance for them to come, you may not end up catching any of the algae eaters at all. A lot of aquaculture farmers are frustrated about this too. They might need to get rid of algae eaters they catch, but there's nowhere to dispose of them. These days, people are very environmentally aware. If you dispose of these fish somewhere out in the open, they're going to create a foul smell, and then someone will report you.
No matter what people do to deal with these invasive fish, it doesn't get to the root of the problem. Treating the problem at its source means stopping people from throwing their pet fish into public waters.
When you're raising this species, you have to take responsibility.
If you really want to have fish as pets, you need to be a responsible pet owner. Before you decide to bring these fish home, before you buy them, you need to be sure that you really want them in your aquarium. Teaching people to think clearly about this is the best way to tackle the issue. These days, the fishery authority is working with larger aquarium retailers to work out a system for collecting fish that people no longer want. The fishery's website also has a form that you can fill out to tell them you have algae eaters you want to get rid of. Submit the form and they'll assess it.
Tropical fish are popular pets, and algae eaters can be a useful addition to aquariums. But when fish are tossed out into an environment where they have no natural predators, they can become a hazard that destroys the ecological balance.